I've been a Manchester United fan since I was 7, but lately things haven't been going so great for Eric and the team. But on the plus side, they do have this beautiful card layout on their website for their posts. So today, that's what I'm going to show you how to build. So this is the card layout I'm going to try and replicate. Now, I'm not going to try and replicate it exactly. I just want to get the main parts in place because you can finesse it to whatever style you want. So this is a post, essentially, and it's in a card. And we have the featured image on the left. We have the post title here. This is the excerpt, but it has this nice background. And it also has these nice little radiuses on the edge. So it's a bit of a challenge. Let's see how we get on. I'm going to use the query loop block to do this. So I'm just going to go /// as the shortcut, query loop, and that'll find the query loop block. And then I'm going to choose a pattern to start with. These are the preset patterns. Now I'm using the 2024 theme. These are the patterns that come with the 2024 theme. So what I'm trying to find here is an approximation of this card layout here, just this single card. Now this one here looks pretty good because it's got the featured image here. It's got the post title and then it's got an excerpt. Yep, that's pretty good. I'm happy with that. So I'm just going to click on that. That's going to bring it into my page. I'm going to do a few things to start with. I'm going to click on the settings panel here and just turn off inherit query from template. Turn that off. As soon as I do that, now I can actually change how many posts I show per page. By default, it will show 10, but I'm actually going to set that as 1 because I only want 1 post to show. I'm also going to do a few other things quickly while I'm here. So I'm going to reduce the size of my title. And again, you can finesse these. I'm just working really quickly. And I'm going to change the number of words in my excerpt. I can just click on the excerpt block and come in here and reduce those. And you can see that changes accordingly. Now it's time to add some style. So I'm not going to have a white background today. I'm going to have a black background just so it's really easy for us to see what's going on. So I'm actually going to select the columns block here, which is part of the blocks that are made up that contain this card layout. Let's make this a bit bigger so we can see what we're doing. And I'm going to style it. So I'm going to come across to the right and click on styles here. And I'm going to set the background to be black. And I'm going to set the text to be white. Now you can see we've got some issues because we've got some padding around this columns block that you get naturally with the columns block, which you normally need, but today I don't need it. So I'm just going to come down to styles here in padding and just remove any padding from the top and the bottom and also from the left and the right. And you can see now we've got that nice flush, sitting flush. I'm actually now going to put some radius on these columns as well because we want these nice little curved edges here. So I'm just going to add a little radius. I'll add quite a big one today so we can see is actually working. There we go. There's the radius. Now I just need to style these a bit more. So when I've used that pattern, it's actually brought it in. The columns are too wide at the moment, whereas these are 50-50, about 50-50. So I'm going to select the column, the left-hand column. You can see within the list view here, this is the left column. This is the right column. And I'm going to come across to settings and I'm just going to set that to be 50%. I'm going to do the same for the right-hand column to set that to be 50% as well. And we're getting there. Now I need to change the proportions of my featured image. So I just select the featured image block, come across to the right in styles, and I'm going to choose this option here, which is 916. That'll change the proportions of Eric. And we're getting there, aren't we? We're pretty close. We've got a few other things to do. This text isn't in the right place. There's a few ways you can do this. The simplest way is just select the column block itself, choose this little icon here where you can change the vertical alignment and select align middle. That'll put it in the middle. Again, I'm not trying to replicate this exactly. I'm just trying to get a nice layout using the query loop block. You can finesse these and you can add padding if you want to on this column to be really precise. I'm going to add a read more link in here. Again, you can put your own text in here, but I'm fine for that. That text is a little bit small, so let's just make that text a bit bigger. That's looking pretty good, isn't it? And then the final thing I think I want to do on this is, can you see how at the moment my featured image has these little rounded corners here and here, whereas these ones don't. They have them on the left, but on the right, they're actually just straight. So I'm going to select the featured image block, click on my styles, come down here to radius, and I'm going to click on that little unlink radius option there. This is where you can set specific radius for specific corners. Essentially, we go left, right, bottom left, bottom right here. And I can put naught in there. And now we have no radius on the right-hand edge of my featured image, but a lovely radius on the left because we put that on the overall columns block itself. And here's a really easy way that you can put two of these side by side showing different posts. And I'm going to use the new grid block to do this. So I'm going to go add before. And then I'm going to go /grid. Now, at the moment, the grid block is only available if you're using the Gutenberg plugin, but it is coming to WordPress 6.6, fingers crossed, in July. So I'm going to add the grid block. Then I'm going to change the settings of the main container of the grid block, come across to the right, and I'm going to say manual, and I want to show two columns. That's setting the base container. Let's make this wide width as well, so it's going to cover the larger area. Now I'm going to move Eric inside that grid block just by dragging him in like that. Looking great. Then I'm going to duplicate Eric. So click on the three dots and go duplicate. So we've got two Erics, which is obviously an issue, but with the second one now, what we can do is we can actually change which post we show. So we're going to use the offset setting that comes with the query loop block, which is this little setting here. So just make sure you have the query loop block selected. This is actually the query loop block. It's just been renamed as a block pattern. Click on that setting there, display settings, and we're going to offset this as one post. And that means it's going to skip the first post, and then it's going to display the second post. And there we go. We had two fantastic card layouts showing different posts just using WordPress blocks. If you found that useful, if you can hit the like button down below now, it'd be fantastic because it does make a huge difference in terms of how many people get to see this video. If you want to see more videos as part of the Build and Beyond series that I'm making with WordPress.com, hit that subscribe button and you'll be notified every time we release a new one. Keep well. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon. Bye for now.